Ji jimbur tu dhan hingmi chang, tu nal phanam jimbur nga gyat tu, pakar dhar ngam san tu shirmir tu, tum da thir che chan la ki shiom char, kar tu kar rin chan nyam bum kar, yon tu kar tu ga yi ki zir tu, tu ni nyam bum ribi, nam jir, lon jir am jir zong ro so ran tu, ma vi sing kim ki rin nyam la char, kin tu zang bur monam nam brash, che gyarum chan le jim zir pa, Jāla mī jāla kī shāṁ sar, nīcāruvār cīrngī jāṅkaṁ sā, jāvār tīkī shīnlo yālār, jīmē pāñcō jāṅlā sūrān, gōr kīr tōpān pāvara shīngī lō.今天我们利用网络国际频道上呢，跟大家一起学习神圣的佛法。今天应该是我们国际法印传法的第二次，记得上次7月7号吧。我希望我们这个应该以后长期的要举行下去。今天跟大家所传的内容，主要是菩提心的修法。菩提心的修法呢，首先我用一些理论上的道理，也跟国内外的对佛教有兴趣的人们呢，简单的宣说与它有关的相关理论。
Today we're using this time through the internet and we gathered together to study Dhamma. And today is the second time through the international website we are together and learning and have this teaching. Last time it's the July 7th. And hopefully we can continue this kind of teaching in the long term and in the future. And today the topic is about bodhicitta, and I'm going to first go through some of the theoretical part of bodhicitta to all of the Dhamma friends in China and abroad.
为什么要今天讲菩提心的修法呢？我们知道我们今天的社会，人类已经到达了21世纪，21世纪是也是一个非常高速发展的这样的一个时代。现在有些人说什么叫做现代人？所谓的现代人就是能在短短的时间当中做许多事情的这样的人叫做是现代人。还有一种说法呢，面临着各种困惑。也就是说，现在社会经济的压力，各个国家与国家之间的为了利益而冲突，就像现在的叙利亚和埃及的各种事件正在发生一样。还有呢，要面对各个国家的一些恐怖分子的袭击，以及呢，人类自由而斗争等等，诸如此类的许多非常复杂的时代当中呢，我们都需要利他心的菩提心。
So, while we are going to talk about the bodhicitta today, because that now we are entering this 21st century, it is a very fast. There's a lot of fast changing in this age, and some people said that what is the modern people? What is modern time? Someone said that probably modern people mean that we can do a lot of work in a very short time, while others said that there are so many struggles, so many competitions in this world, something like recently in Syria and Egypt, there's a lot of bad news we're hearing from, and also the attacks. And also people think they are struggling for freedom and so on and so forth. So this time is kind of a complicated and a very fast age.
我们今天压降发菩提心的主要的原因呢，因为它是所有佛教的核心，而且这样的尼塔的发心是不仅是佛教当中它是一个最重要的这个修行，在现在任何一个世界上的国家的人都需要这样的一种利他心，精进的利他心或者是大悲心呢，跟这个菩提心有很大的差别。一般的利他心和悲心呢，实际上以基督教为主的，实际上的很多的宗教呢，都有帮助他人的这样的心。但是从菩提心的层面来讲呢，不仅是暂时要帮助他，而且是从根本上，从实际上解决众生的大问题和大烦恼、大痛苦。所以我们每一个人要了解菩提心的这种具体的意义和它的价值所在是非常重要的。
So the reason that we are teaching bodhicitta today is because that bodhicitta is the core of the Mahayana, is the core of the Dharma, and also in this world, not only for Buddhists, but also all the nations, all the peoples, they all need such kind of heart to help others, to benefit others. Of course, other religions also talk about such kind of practice, such as compassion, love, kindness, and so on, and this kind of elements. But in Buddhism, we are not going to help people in short term, but in long term. But eventually, we want to liberate such beings from this world. So that's why we are teaching bodhicitta today.
为什么我刚才讲一般的悲心跟菩提心有很大的差别？一般的悲心，对一个很好的老师，一个很好的上师、善知识的话呢，都应该会记住的。比如说这个弟子，在他面前亲近的时候，这个人对他很温和，很慈祥，很慈悲，很爱护他，经常呢去帮助，也经常不说什么你的过失，这也只是具有一般的大悲心的上师。但如果这个上师具有菩提心的话呢，他发现这个弟子相续当中有傲慢心、有嫉妒心或者有其他的烦恼的时候呢，他不会顾及你这个弟子心里高兴或不高兴，一定会是通过各种方式来会批评你，根除你的相续当中的这样的不良的这种习气。在这个时候很有可能这个弟子呢逆开上师，但作为真正具有法相的善知识来讲呢，他不会想着自己的利益，应该一心一意的向导这个弟子的将来的根本问题。所以我们经常在生活当中发现，一般的慈悲心跟彻底帮助他人的菩提心之间有着天壤之别。
So we're talking about bodhicitta. Bodhicitta is very different from the general compassion. And for the general compassion or general loving kindness, we could see that general teachers, lamas, gurus, probably they all have this kind of compassion. For example, this teacher could be very, very gentle, very soft, and he also cared for his disciples, his students, and in this way, his students feel that, oh, this is a very compassionate teacher, and because he's never scolded me. But for a guru, for a master with authentic bodhicitta, probably he will directly point out the bad thing, like the ego, the jealousy, the pride of that disciple, no matter if the disciple is happy or not, because this guru, what he really cares about is the liberation, is the liberation of his disciples, instead of if he's happy or not with any words.
所以我们在座的人也应该要分析，一般来讲，具有很好的心态的一个老师来讲呢，他会有对他的相关的人员有一种爱心，也有一种包容心。但是真正的菩提心呢，我们很难以发现这个人的相续当中具不具足，因为有了菩提心的话呢，不管是自己或者是他人，他一定会是摧毁我们自信当中的我和我所知。我和我所知呢，实际上从佛教的意义来讲，它就是一切轮回的根本。从我们实践当中来讲呢，因为自我性、自私性太强的人呢，实际上他不会帮助别人。正因为是这样，这个弥勒菩萨。就弥勒菩萨呢，他在相关专论当中也是说过，说是发心为利他，求真什么就是求真登菩提，也就是说呢就是菩提心呢需要两种具备，有一种呢是完全的付出，一种奉献利益。无条件的利益天下不变的一切生命一切众生，还有一种条件呢，就是说所谓的菩提心呢，实际上是真正的能求到一切万事万物的真相。所以我们在这个世界上呢，所有的思想当中，所有的精神当中，最可贵的是什么呢？就是利他心和求真心。
So when we talk about a person, he's a good person, and he with a very good mind, and he is nice and tolerant to the people around him. But when we talking about bodhicitta, it is very hard to see that if one has bodhicitta or not, because the bodhicitta, its main purpose is to destroy ego. And when we talk about ego, ego is the main cause, the root cause of one in samsara, prevent someone from liberation. So with the ego, one cannot really help others. That's why material in the elements of clear realization said that for bodhicitta, there's two aspects. The first one is to benefit others, and to care about the welfare of others. And the second point, the second aspect, is to really understand the truth of all these phenomena. So these two aspects is the most precious mind that deserves us to looking for.
所谓的菩提心呢，菩提心的修法，菩提心的理论呢，现在的很多西方国家的人也是非常欢喜，包括我们现在在东南和东方国家的这些人们呢，也是对菩提心的菩提心越来越重视。最近呢。我们准备在网络上给大家做开示，选择这个题目的时候呢，那么就是有相当多的人要求讲菩提心的修法。前一段时间我去美国的时候呢，也是有些大学当中呢，也是要求讲自他交换的菩提心。所以我想呢，我本人来讲，在今生当中呢，应该很愿意。跟大家共同学习菩提心的有关的理论和修法。
So talking about bodhicitta, its theory and its practice, Rinpoche said many people really like it. And also in different countries, so many people, they are learning bodhicitta more and more. And also talking about this teaching, many people, earlier ago, many people already asked for the teaching of bodhicitta. And also Rinpoche mentioned that recently when he was in U.S., some university also asked Rinpoche to give a teaching about the Swiss one and oneself and others, which is also about bodhicitta practice.
我要讲菩提心呢，下面有，从三个方面来分析。第一个是讲尼他心，第二个呢，讲求真啊，就是求真我、求真心。第三个呢，就是讲一些具体的简单修法。
So, just now, Rinpoche also mentioned for himself, he said his prefer always teaching and share practice, share bodhicitta practice with all of you. And his following teaching, Rinpoche said he will talking about three aspects. The first one is the benefiting others, the benefiting others, this mind. And the second one is he will talking about the enlightenment. And the third one is talking about the practice of bodhicitta.
首先第一个利他心呢，我用三个方面来相分析。第一个呢，就是要讲到利他心是一切佛法的根本，不仅仅是它是大乘佛法的根本。我等大师释迦牟尼佛转第一乘法论，也就是说转第一转法论四谛法论的时候呢，相关的经典当中讲。大悲心是一切佛法的根本，大悲心呢一切功德的基础。所以我们在座的人，如果你要想真正了解佛法的话，首先是应该有一种慈悲菩提心。我们平常人经常也是说佛教以慈悲为怀，也就是说大悲菩提心呢应该是所有佛教徒和所有善良人的基本的基础，也就是说他的他就是指的是利他心。
So talking about the first one, benefiting others, Rinpoche mentioned that this is the core of Dharma, not only for Mahayana teaching, but only like the Theravada teaching. And at that time, Shakyamuni Buddha already mentioned that compassion or benefiting others, this kind of mind is the root of all practice and also it's the root of all merits. So if you want to learn Dharma, if you want to become a Buddhist, you have to have a compassionate mind, and with that you could learn Dharma. So this is a basic requirement for Buddhists.
因为利他心呢，实际上我们每一个众生都需要，所有的众生跟我一样的愿意获得快乐，不愿意得到痛苦，而且别人的痛苦跟我的痛苦呢也是一样的。如果我以尽心尽力来帮助他的话呢，他会无比的欢喜。再说无论是自己的痛苦还是他人的痛苦，我们通过人事正理，通过继续修炼的话呢，那么这样的自私的痛苦呢可以遣除。这种利他的快乐呢都可以增上。因此利他心呢，我们每一个人都有可能通过训练、通过修行、通过学习呢越来越增上。而自私自利心呢对自他来讲就像是毒药一样的，应该是有害处的。那么这种害心呢，我们逐渐的通过训练以后也可以迁除。现在人们经常讲一般的一个习惯呢在21天当中它可以改变。所以我原来的一种自私的心，原来的一种毒恶的心的话呢，那么通过修炼就它可以改变。
Every sentient beings, every people, every person needs this compassion mind, needs to benefit others. And in the way that all others are just similar as just similar with oneself, because that everybody, every social beings, we want happiness and we do not want suffering. And also, if I can try my best to help others, and both myself and others will be very happy. And also through practice, we can also through sufferings. After we experience sufferings, if we have a right view, we can learn truth through the experience of sufferings, and we can become maybe, and we can attain the true happiness. Talking about this happiness and talking about this benefiting others, and through practice, the Buddha said we can all increase, we can all cultivate this habit and make it as part of ourselves. On the other hand, when we talk about ego is just like a drug, like a poison to oneself and others, and also it can be seized or it can be reduced through practice. And the Buddha take an example saying that people said if you have a habit, and probably it just take 21 days through certain proper method, and you can get rid of that kind of habit.
第二个方面，就我们自己和他人的关系，也就是说呢，我们表面上看呢，可能自己比他人更要重要。现在很多人认为是要有一种自我的强大。自我的成功，自我的完善，有这样的一种勇气和有一种竞争感，但实际上呢，我们都应该清楚，无论是从世间法，从佛法两个层面来分析呢，实际上应该利他的心呢，就是比自我的心还重要。从世间法分析呢。利他的心，实际上，对我们世间的任何，不管是家庭当中也好，还是在社会的任何一个部门和集体当中呢，如果有利他心的人呢，人人都喜欢他，人人都需要这个人加入我们的集团，加入我们的组织。从佛法的处世间法方面讲呢，不管是修任何法。念任何经，或者说是做任何的佛事的话呢，以利他心的趋势下做的功德和以自利心的趋势下做的功德呢，那就是完全是不能相提并论的。也就是说，以利他心的这个心态下所做的功德呢，远远超过自私自利的心。所以说是，这是从两方面来分析呢，应该是我们以一种利他性的这种做任何的事呢，实际上对自己也是带来无比的力量，对他人的话呢，直接或者间接呢，也获得了无限的这种利益。
So the second part is talking about the relationship between oneself and others. People usually think that I myself is more important than the others. So I want to be success. I want to success. I want to compete with others. I want to perfect myself. But if you really analyze either from the worldly point of view or either from the point of view of Buddha of Dharma teaching, it's all wrong. For example, if you have a mind of benefiting others, if you are very kind, very compassionate, and either you are in a family or in a company, because you can help others, so many people will like you and want to stay with you. And from the point of view of Dharma teaching, and we also we always talking about motivation. Suppose you are doing some kind of practice, different motivation makes very different results. If you have a motivation to benefit others, benefit all social beings, or if you have a motivation just to just want to benefit yourself, and the merit of that exactly same practice will make a very great difference.
第三个方面，讲在我们修尼塔的过程当中呢，实际上，众生对我们的恩德很大，因为在我们的修行，在我们的实际生活当中呢，如果没有出现所有的这个众生，包括怨恨的敌人，或者说世间当中的素不相识的人们，如果他们没有出现的话，我们的任何事业很难以推进。从实践的角度来讲，我们无论是坐车、乘飞机，或者说上班，或者说跟这个家人啊一起，就是享用任何的生活的话，实际上在我们生活当中，他人是非常关键的、离不开的一种元素一种因缘。从佛法层面来讲呢，我们修到发菩提心，中间就是心持六度万行，最后呢，就成就这个佛教的任何一个果位呢，实际上众生都是不可缺少的。
So then, we can talking about the kindness or the value of such beings, and we can see that in practice, without such beings, we cannot do anything. Suppose like you are taking a car or you are taking an airplane, or if you go to work or if you enjoy it with yourself. And other sentient beings is always a very important factor in this circumstance, because without any sentient beings, including with either without enemy, without a stranger, and nothing can happen. And from the and also we can talk about the Dharma practice. And at the very beginning of Dharma practice, you need the motivation to benefit all sentient beings. And during the procedure, you need finish the six perfections, such as the generosity or patience and so on. And finally, until you attain the full enlightenment to become a Buddhahood, all of this you cannot put sentient beings aside and just to do by yourself.
关于这件事情呢，印度有个非常著名的论师，他叫吉天菩萨，他在非常殊胜的论点叫《入菩萨行论》，在这里面呢也讲过，说是任何一个人如果非常尊重佛陀，而不尊重或者不尊敬众生的话呢，这是没有道理，就是岂有此理。为什么这么讲呢？因为佛教的任何一个成就呢，实际上离不开我们众生的因缘，包括怨恨的敌人。如果我们的修道当中没有出现怨敌，那修安忍，或者说是到这个就寂静的地方去，相续金女波罗蜜多等等，诸如此类的许多的修正都没有办法实现。因此呢，我想，刚才我们得过的得语来，讲考的时候呢，就说我们家庭或者单位都要抛弃到寂静的地方去。其实这是论点当中也有这样的说明，但是这个是最初学者来讲的，初学者需要远离一种非常杂乱的环境，非常复杂的这种人群，因为所有的这些梵语对我们带来困惑带来危害，带来烦恼。但是到一定的时候，佛教当中的进一步的更高的这种层次的修行当中呢，实际上众生都是不离开的。尤其是如果没有一个怨恨的敌人的出现的话呢，那我们的修行呢都绝对不会成功的。
And Rinpoche said, in India, a great bodhisattva, a great bodhisattva, Shakyamuni, said in his treatise called The Way to Bodhisattva, he said that it doesn't make any sense if, for one, he just respect Buddha, but not respect all such beings, because without such beings, also without any bad enemies, you cannot even do any practice about patience. And also because also without all of the such beings, and you needn't go to a quiet place just to do meditation, because all of the such beings provides you a condition for practice. And just now, Rinpoche mentioned in our oral exam, the friend from Germany, and she said that it is good to leave the city, leave the family, and to a quiet place to practice. And Rinpoche said it is very good for beginners, because for beginners, you really need a quiet place to concentrate all your teaching or what you learn. But later on, if you want to get more practice, and you have to stay with such beings, and without such beings, your practice cannot make any progress.
刚才我们前面就是讲利他心，利他心呢，就是讲第一个说是佛教的根本。第二个呢，讲自他的这个观心；第三个呢，就讲到了这个众生的需要，也就是说众生的恩德。那么这三者呢，结合起来，总结起来，让我们今天在座的人应该好好的思考一下。实际上，你是真正用一种修行，用一种真理来完善自己、净化自己、改变自己的话呢，那么首先我们的不好的习气、不好的习惯、不好的这种心态呢，一定要有一种改变。这种改变呢，不是一个理论上，或者说是文字上，或者说是心想上，应该是在从内心深处，从根本上。要得到解决，要得到解决的时候呢，先从理论上明白，我们来到这个世界，也就是说人生呢，苦短，就最多也是几十年。那么在这个过程当中，所有的思想当中最有意义的、最有价值的是什么呢？说实在，前辈的这些诸佛菩萨和高僧大德呢，也是一口通声的说是利他心。像我这样的一个魔学后学者的话呢，我也翻阅过很多的时间和出世间的经论，也接触过许多的一些老师，在这些理论和在这些体验结合起来的时候呢，说实在，所有的人类的这种思想进化当中呢，利他心呢是真正的智慧的体悟。
So just now we are talking about the mind of benefiting others. It is the root. It is the core of Dharma teaching. And also we explained the relationship between oneself and others. And why do we need such beings? So as a summary, probably we should really think about it. If you want to practice in order to perfect yourself, in order to get rid of all your bad habits, and then how to do it? How can you get rid of all these bad habits, bad inhibitions completely? And we should know that first, theoretically, we should know that we are in this world, And with this short lifetime, what is the most precious teaching? What is the most precious thinking? Nambutia said that from past and to future, all Bodhisattvas, all Buddhas, they all think that benefiting others is the most important thing. And for Rinpoche himself, and like he translated so many Dhamma books, and he also he discussed talking with so many intellectuals in universities, and they all agree that benefiting others is the most important thing that we need to learn.
如果我们简单的一个比喻来说的话，实际上的任何冲突、任何争论呢，应该可以总结出一个结论。这种结论呢，那么这些冲突和这些矛盾呢，好多的凡夫人、凡愚呢，他们为了自己的利益，为了自己的目标呢，就是对对方。开始进行争吵、斗争、战争，就像一个家庭来讲，家里的就是吵架啊，就家里的家庭的这种矛盾呢，应该是家人就是不管是丈夫也好，妻子也好，都是他为自己的利益，然后对方呢就提出一些要求。最后之间就开始发生这个争吵。作为一个国家来讲，比如说不管是日本也好，美国也好，俄罗斯也好，还有这个其他的任何国家与国家之间的冲突，地区与地区之间的冲突，民族与民族之间的冲突呢，都应该不外乎是就以自己的利益出发，以自己的这种目标呢，就是作为这个主要的这种自己所发现的这个愿望的这么一个这个因缘来开始进行成长。所以说呢，我们前辈的大德们呢都讲到了，说是一切痛苦的来源呢就是自私自利的心，一切快乐的来源呢实际上是利他心。
For example, Rinpoche said, if we observe all kinds of struggles, we can get a conclusion. What is that? So many such beings or so many persons, and in order to fulfill their aim, in order to satisfy their own benefits, they always need to fight with others. Just like in family, any struggle, any fightings, probably they all come from the benefit of oneself. They want to satisfy their own benefit, and if they cannot solve it, probably there will arguments, there will fightings, and even for a country such as the U.S., Japan, Russia, and all different countries, as Rinpoche said, there's so many conflicts, and they all comes from people's view. Because they thought their benefit is the first, their benefit is more important than others, so the relations between different countries, all the conflicts between different countries, between different nations, between different regions, they all comes from the benefit of oneself. That's why all great masters and virtues, they said that the suffering where suffering comes from, all suffering comes from the selfish, the people, all coming from people's desire that want to satisfy their own benefits.
这样的利他心呢，在我们平时的生活当中呢，也要修炼。修行的方法是非常多的，但最主要的吉天菩萨有一个非常著名的偈颂说是菩提心宝呢为增没有升起呢愿它升起来。这样的菩提心宝已经升起来了呢愿它日益增长。那么这个偈颂呢在我们藏传佛教的很多修行人无论是早上起来晚上睡觉 或者说白天就是做任何工作当中呢，经常念诵，经常观修它，经常呢用这个偈颂来要求自己，反观自己，并且呢在利益众生的过程当中呢，经常像以这样的偈颂来进行加持和赐予这个就是一种美好的祝福，当当全时是用这么样的这种偈颂来就是在生活当中就是经常运用。
The Buddha said there are many different methods for cultivate bodhicitta, for the practice of bodhicitta. But the main teaching, he said, should be a teaching from Shatadeva Bodhisattva. And he said that for those who doesn't have bodhicitta in his mind, and let's hope that he could arouse bodhicitta in his mind. And for those who already have bodhicitta in his mind, andWe also in hope to solidify this kind of mind and do not let it slide. And Rinpoche also mentioned that for Tibetan practitioners, they always chatting this teaching. And no matter in the early morning or when they are having lunch at noon or whatever doing, they always chatting this data and receive blessings from.This teaching and treat this teaching as the most and treat it as the most important teaching in their life.
这是我讲到刚才第一个问题，这发心为利他当中的这利他，然后下面呢就是求真等菩提啊，就是求真等菩提。那么求真等菩提呢，实际上首先我们要知道。就是什么是正悟？实际上，我们现在不管是眼睛看到的、耳朵听到的，或者说每天执着为自己，执着为前面的任何的这个事物啊，这些呢，这是我们无关跟自己的分别念，去开始而取的这种一种因缘。但实际上，他这样的这种执着呢？并没有完全的让深入玩法的真正的究竟事项，而且呢他的这种执着和缘起上呢有一定的误区和有一定的错误，所以我们不管是人和众生呢，现在我们的所见所闻当中呢还有一些不正确的地方，因此呢从中需要醒悟，从中需要觉醒过来。
Just now, Rinpoche already talked about the mind of benefiting others. Then the other aspect of bodhicitta is enlightenment. So when we're talking about enlightenment, we have to know what is enlightenment.As we certain beings, we can see, we can hear, and also we assume this is me, this is he, and this is self, and this is others. But these are all conceived by some raw conceptions, and which generates the subject and object in our world. And this is not the correct truth. And also, because of we have this misunderstanding, we have these misconceptions, and then it will induce many other things that is not a correct view of this world.
刚才就是我们讲的是什么是正悟啊，就是什么是正悟。那么为什么要正悟呢？我们所有的这些众生，我们的感觉、我们的想法、我们的追求，都有一定的这种误区，都不是很真实的。那么这一点不是我们佛教徒讲的，实际上。 从现在的科学来进行观察的话，也会明白其中的道理。那么为什么要是这样的这种迷惑当中、迷乱当中需要醒觉呢？我们必须要承认，在我们的智慧呢，实际上是还有带有一种染污。当这个染污到一定的时候，要会消灭。当这个消灭这种染污呢，那么我们佛教当中呢，叫这个业和烦恼。佛教当中有一个非常著名的论师，叫做是龙猛菩萨啊，就是龙猛论师。那么他曾经呢，也是相关的历史当中讲，就活了就是300年，也有600年的说法。不管是他到底就是在这个人间住了多少年，实际上他确实是非常长寿的一个智者。那么他说过，我们相续当中的业和烦恼断除之后呢，才能现前真正的真我的智慧。
So now we are talking about what is enlightenment and why we should attain enlightenment. Because that just now we explained that because we have this misunderstanding, because we have these misconceptions, and this caused us to looking for or to search something in wrong direction. And this kind of misconception is not taught in the Dharma, but also if we learn some science in the modern science, we can also understand part of those realities. So that's why we need to seek enlightenment because if we do not seek this kind of enlightenment, if we do not to cultivate our wisdom, then ourself, our mind is contaminated by the bad thing and which we call the karma and emotions. Rinpoche said in India, and also another great bodhisattva called Nagarjuna, and in history someone said he lived for 300 years, and others said that he lived for 600 years, and no matter how long he had been living, but he is a very great master, and he said that it is the karma, it is the afflicted emotions that cause us to stay in this samsara and prevent us from liberation and prevent us from getting enlightenment.
这样的证悟呢，在我们每个凡夫众生还没有获得，不获得证悟的根本原因呢？就是所谓的无明，因为无明呢，就染上了我们的智慧，就像是一个纯净的水晶球，但是外面有一些垢染的话，那么就是不能见到它的本来的面目。所以这种无明呢，我们每一个人就必须要消除。
So the reason that we cannot attain enlightenment right now is because that we have ignorance, and the root cause of making us as sentient beings instead of wisdom is because that this because we have this kind of ignorance, just like the crystal ball, which is very clear, but it was covered by dirty, and then we cannot see the true face of this crystal ball.
刚才前面讲的是什么是证悟，第二个是为什么要证悟，那么我想第三个呢，就是讲的这样断除无明，也就是说刚才讲的所有的这些万事万物的真相，不能照见的根本原因是无明。那么无明呢，实际上是一种费力作业，它并不是在我们的心的本心上存在的，它是一种偶然性的，它是一种后然性的。那么我们通过修行，通过 学习呢可以端出它，它端出的这种方法呢，佛陀在佛经当中就是向过一切因缘法啊，此法皆空性，也就是说，凡是所有的这些因缘法的东西呢，都是空性的。那么无明呢，它也是是一种因缘而这个产生的。那么我们什么时候真悟到一切万法是皆是空性的这个真理的时候呢？那么所有的这些无明呢，就完全的就像阳光照射的时候呢，那么这个无云呢，也就是说迷雾呢，就是自然清除一样的，就全部会这个烟消云散。
So we are talking about the root cause that prevent us from seeing the truth is ignorance. Then how to get rid of this ignorance? How to remove this ignorance? And then it is said that ignorance is just an improper mental activities. So because it is not the nature of mind, so it can be extinguished by proper method, by proper practice. And also Buddha said in his teaching that everything, if it is arising if it is a dependent arising, then it must be emptiness. It must be empty. And similarly, because ignorance is a dependent arising, it is so it is not the nature of mind. So it could be eliminated. And when we realize the emptiness, when we realize that all phenomena are empty, and by this wisdom, empty, and we could get rid of this ignorance, just like when the sun comes out, and all the fogs will disappear.
最后，就是第四个问题呢，我想讲，先证佛果，先证佛果，也就是说。刚才前面就是讲到，如果我们什么时候证悟一切万法皆是空性的这样的道理的时候呢，那么我们相续当中的障碍、无明、无解，以及各种不合理的分别呢，全部会清除。这叫做佛教当中就是说断除障碍，断除障碍。同时呢。我们会认识到一切万物万事万物的真正的本来面目，一切万事万物的真正的本来面目。那么万事万物的真正的本来面目是什么呢？实际上，除了现象以外，它的本质呢，丝毫也是得不到，丝毫也是不存在。这种不存在呢，也并不是一个单空，它是。在佛教的中观当中所抉择的那样，远离四边八系的一种真相。这种真相呢，到一定的时候呢，我们每一个人，包括我们今天在座的东西方和各个国家和各个民族的人呢，都可以通达。只不过呢，现在正在努力的这个道上而已。
So now we are talking about the Buddhahood, to attain Buddhahood. So when we realized emptiness, when we cultivated the wisdom of emptiness, and at that time we could get rid of all our afflictions, all our emotions, all our obstructions, and all that improper mental activities. And by realizing or by recognizing the true face of all phenomena, which is that it is not just the phenomena, but besides the phenomena, there's nothing, there's no essence, there's no self, no truly, or no, there's no inherent existence. By realizing that, and we could see that we attain the wisdom of emptiness, and that is the enlightenment. And this kind of enlightenment is not that nothing existence, but this wisdom is beyond any extremes, like there is phenomena or there's no phenomena, and through analysis of middle way, we could know that it's beyond any words and beyond any extremes. So for us, all of us today, and we are still learning this kind of teaching, and no matter where you are from, which nation, where you are in this world, finally one day, what you said, we could achieve this kind of enlightenment.
在韩传佛教的禅宗当中讲，有明心见性的说法。在藏传佛教的密法当中呢，就是叫这个认识信心，就是或者说认识觉性，也有这样的说法。还有一些先宗的般若宗，就先宗的个别宗派当中呢，就叫这个真悟空性，就真悟空性。无论是任何宗派的说法，实际上就是说我们的心呢，完全到达了最究竟的这种真相。也就是说呢，我们认识一切万法的本来它具有的空性和显现无二无别的这么一个真理。这种真理的认识者呢，谁是认识者呢？最究竟的就是佛，然后还没有得到佛的中间的过程呢，叫做是菩萨，菩萨。所以我们在座的人呢，不要认为是佛是好像世界当中的一个天人或者是一个圣，而且所谓的菩萨呢，好像是在世间当中呢，就层次比较高一点的一种灵魂，就是借着这种说法呢，是不对的。应该是佛，所谓的佛菩萨呢，在我们人类的这个层次上呢，应该说对万事万物的真相呢，完全通达的一种觉悟者。佛就是觉悟者的意思。所以我们佛教并不是自称是自己是觉悟者，实际上佛陀现在给留下来的这些经典来可以说明我们后人应该所追求的目标。
And number two said, this kind of enlightenment, the wisdom, in the Han Buddhism, like in Zen, and also in Tibetan schools and also other schools of Mahayana, they have different languages such as recognize the true nature of your mind or realize emptiness and so on. And although they have all different languages, but they all said the same thing, which is to guide people or bring people to the truth of all phenomena, let people to recognizing or realize the truth of all phenomena. And for those who have the ultimate wisdom of recognizing this truth, and we call Buddha, and all the way to realizing all the truth of phenomena, we call Bodhisattva. So usually, and we could see that usually people assume a Buddha is just a god or some beings, and Bodhisattva is kind of a high level soul, and this is all raw view. And from our human level, we can see that what is Buddha meaning? It is just a person who completely awakened from this misconception, from ignorance. And also, in all of the teachings of Buddha, he taught us how to achieve this kind of enlightenment.
睡着了怎么办我？开玩笑，不是我，是你们。怎么不翻译？
The Buddha said he seems he's sleeping, but he's not joking with himself. He's saying some others they might sleep.
Like
fall to sleep.
当然，如果睡着了也是正常现象，现在是晚上。
But if you really fall asleep, it's also okay because it's night, it's evening.
不过对美国人来说也不一定。
But for people in US, it's morning, so it shouldn't sleep.
刚才讲到这个所谓的 fall 啊，实际上是确实我们要知道，得到 fall 过呢，并不是说是一种得到胜的过位啊，不是这个意思。因此我们要想帮助别人呢，可能最大利益的帮助呢，一个是就近的利他的菩提心，还有一个就近的求证的菩提心。这种求证的菩提心呢，要解决众生的生死痛苦，或者说解决众生的实质的这个问题，必须要证悟空性。如果没有证悟空性，虽然有些老师他会给学生讲一些他的技术、他的智能技巧，但实际上呢，也解决不能就是根本上的问题。我以前在一个学校里面演讲的时候，有一个老师，他说他非常关心学生，包括对学生的感情啊、谈朋友啊这些的，天天的是忙着这件事情，所以这个老师很关心他们，但实际上是这个解决不了大的问题。应该最能解决问题的呢，就是我们性的本性，就完全就明白一切玩法的真相，完全明白的话呢，那么这就是最大的这种觉悟，最大的觉悟。我们每一个人需要这样，所以菩提心的最重的要求呢，让我们每一个人、每一个众生呢，早一点就得到觉悟。
So as we talked about just now, to become Buddha or attain the enlightenment is not saying that when someone is Buddha and he became some kind of god or some kind of sentient beings, it's not about that. And we're talking about to helping others and how to really help others, and we do need bodhicitta, and it has two aspects. It has two aspects, as we mentioned just now. One is benefiting others, and the other one is to achieve enlightenment by yourself. So if you want to solve the problem like birth and death, and to solve problem of that sickness, aging, and all kinds of this problem, we have to realize the aptness. We have to get this kind of wisdom. And Rinpoche said when he gave a lecture in a university, and he met a professor, and that professor said that she really cared about her students, about their job problem, and about their emotion problem, and all everything. But this is good on one hand, but if you want to really help others, the key is that you have to realize the aptness. You have to realize the true nature of your mind, and for those people who get this point, and this is the biggest enlightenment.
这是我以上有通过四个方面来分析求证的道理。下面呢，我再讲最后简单的讲一下自他交换的菩提心。菩提心的修法非常多，也有自他平等的菩提心的修法，自他交换的菩提心的修法，还有自轻他重的菩提心的修法，以及有一些先宗和密宗的一些窍诀性的修法。那么今天呢，我们简单的跟大家说一下自他交换的菩提心。自他交换呢，从实践的简单的一个浅显易懂的名词来说的话呢，就是我们实践当中经常非常有意义的一种说法，叫做是换位思考。不单是要换位思考，还要呢就是换位的就是利他。方位的应该做有意义的事。
So we just explained that why do we need enlightenment? And then we can, and now we are talking about some practice of bodhicitta. Today we'll, Rinpoche said that he will give a simple teaching of the switch of self and others. Actually, there are many practice of bodhicitta in either Mahayana or Vajrayana, because such as the equality of self and others, all assume one is all assume others is more important than others, and also there are so many instructions in Vajrayana teaching that help us to cultivate bodhicitta mind. And but he said, just in a simple words, when we're talking about the switch between self and others, it is just exactly same as we are talking about to think about others in their opposition, or just to try to help others by visualize that you are all his position and do some meaningful things to help others.
这种修法呢，在我们藏传佛教当中，就是有非常殊胜的一些窍诀性的修法，尤其是藏传佛教里面在该居派的紫檀小丸是非常出名的，有一个名言呢，叫做是失败快损自去说，神灵利益奉献他。也就是说，在平时的我们日常生活当中呢，我们有很多不公平的待遇，自己得到亏损、得到失败的时候呢，那么经常没有抱怨心、没有怨恨心呢，就自己就成熟，自己坚强起来，然而将自己的一些利益啊，将自己的一些成功啊，将自己的一些各方面的一些浮云呢，就尽量的直接或者是间接奉献给他，帮助给他。那么这样的精神呢，它是不仅是现在这个时代当中，在过去的时代当中，将来这个未来乃至人类生存的这个世界当中呢，这种精神是应该是最高尚的一种修行。
So even we are talking about, even we're talking about the practice of switching oneself and others, there's also many instructions in Tibetan Buddhism. Just like the many masters of Gardangpa, and they always through their teaching, they always tell us that the practice of bodhicitta is mainly to cultivating such a mind that is to giving all profit and all gains to others, and taking all defeat and all loss to ourselves, and in this way we can help others. And when we have failure, when we have so many frustrations, we should not complain, and we should sustain by ourselves. And when we have so many successful things, and when we have so many happiness, we should give this to other people, and this spirit is needed right now, and not only right now, but in the past, it is the most excellent mind, and even if in the future, for the whole human society, we all need this kind of mind.
这种修行方法刚开始的时候。可能跟我们的平常的习惯性呢有一点矛盾，或者说人们很容易就没办法接受，但实际上如果你长期的修学，久而久之呢，自己的思想就是一定会是成熟，当你菩提心越来越修得纯熟的时候呢，你才会知道在我们这个世界上最可怕的就是自私自利的心，有了自利的心呢，它会不断的危害其他的众生，有了利他的心呢，它会不断的扰于或者是造福我们的人类和 整个世界。所以这种心态呢，我们需要一种长期的训练，长期的一种修行，甚至我们心主作我的唯一当中呢，经常也要有一种利他的心的不断的这种修炼。尤其是我们所修的这种自他交换的菩提心呢，实际上是它是非常兼而一心的，应该在实际操作当中呢，它并没有非常复杂的仪轨，在任何一个场合当中呢，它都可以就自己就信持。所以说呢，我想我们在座的人呢，应该就是要多学习这个菩提心的利益。其实菩提心的利益呢，在《如菩萨心论》第一品当中讲过的。如果我们懂到了菩提心的功德之后，再进一步的学习《如心论》的所有的内容，然后再进一步的学习呢，就像《菩萨学记论》呐，还有呢，就是大乘摄大乘论，还有包括这个尼玛巴的非常殊胜的窍诀，讲大圆满心性修习的第八品当中呢，有了非常广泛的教理的菩提心的理论和修法。
So, we explained the bodhicitta and also the practice of it, one of the method which is to switch oneself and others. And probably for beginners, when we already get used to our previous habits, and it's kind of difficult for us to accept it right away. But if you can practice it persistently and if you can practice more and more, and this kind of mind will get kind of mature in your mind, then at a certain level you will finally realize that in this world the most horrible thing is the ego. With the ego you will do harm to others, you will hurt others, but without ego you can greatly benefit others. So we really need to learn the benefit of bodhicitta, to practice bodhicitta. And also, when we are talking about this practice of switching oneself and others, it is very simple, and you can practice it anytime, at anywhere, either walking or sitting or eating, anytime and anywhere you can practice to cultivate this mind. And Limbuchi said that he really wish all of us to learn about the benefit of bodhicitta. There's so many Mahayana sutras explain and talking about bodhicitta. And for example, the guidance of the bodhicitta of life, and also the resting mind, and so many Mahayana teachings, they all have very detailed explanations about bodhicitta.
所以在Mahayana 的提示当中啊，大乘的教诀当中，应该说讲的是三殊胜的教诀啊，三殊胜就是。我们刚开始的时候呀，我要修任何一个法，就是要为了利益众生而修。然后中间呢，修这座法的时候，就自己心不散乱的性质。到最后呢，我所修的这些功德和所修的这些法呢，就是要回向给众生。这是在大乘佛教当中最关键的，最重要的一个法门。因此，如果不具足这样的大乘菩提心的法呢，按照大乘来讲，它是一种心想的法，也就是说，每天都是以自私，刚开始修的时候，以自私自利心的修，然后中间呢，也是自私自利心的执着不放弃，到最后也是自私自利的心，回想自己的话呢， 它是一个小乘或者说是比较底层的一种修法。因此呢，我也特别希望我们在座的很多的佛教徒呢，你的修行呢一定要具有这个菩提心来摄测。即使一些今天在座的一些非佛教徒，有些是非宗教徒的话呢，你要正面的了解，实际上所谓的菩提心呢，它并不是一个宗教的一种具有教条性的一种狭隘的思想。如果你广泛的深入的了解菩提心的内涵的时候呢，你会很惊讶你会感到无比的这种震荡震惊，因为他的这种思想的微妙性，他的思想的这种无限的力量呢，在我们当今这个科学机器发达的时代当中呢，也是难以寻觅的。所以说呢，我今天呢也是将近一个多小时的时间当中呢，也很难以讲出许多包罗万象的这样的一种哲理，但是呢更重要的事情，以简单的语言来说明菩提心呢，实际上是利他和求证两个层面，但这两个层面呢，并不是佛教独一的一种说法，我们所有人类呢，需要所追求的一个长远的目标。
And for all our practice, Rinpoche said there's a very important instruction, which is called the three wholesomeness, which means that at the beginning of your practice, you should have a motivation of benefiting all sentient beings. And during your practice, you have to one pointedly focus on your practice. And in the end, when you finish your practice, you need to dedicate all the merit you collected through the practice to all sentient beings. So if you don't have this kind of motivation, or you don't have any dedication, and just put the practice at kind of a formality, or if you just practice with a selfish motivation, and probably you could just give very little or even no merit, or probably you practice Mahayana, and but you fall into the Hinayana Hinayana practice. So Rinpoche said he really hope that we do all our practice and guided by the bodhicitta mind, and also maybe today we have some other elders who are not religious or who are not Buddhist, but also you should know that even if you are not a Buddhist, and you should know that this is not bodhicitta teaching is not just a very narrow-minded teaching, a very strict doctrine, but it is has a very vast and profound meanings. Once you learn about it, once you have some understanding of bodhicitta, you will be amazed. And because finally, the Buddha said, and because during today it's a very short time, and he cannot explain in very much detail to explain the bodhicitta, and just in simple words, Rinpoche said he just want to tell you that bodhicitta, it has two things. One is to benefit others, and the other is to achieve enlightenment by yourself, and with that you can really benefit others. And this is a very sophisticated teaching, and also it has very very inconceivable powers that even we use the most modern science, we cannot detect its real effects.
菩提心的修法呢，基本上都讲完了然后我在这里还要说一简单的几个事情 不会耽误很长时间。我知道你们很多人很关心，睡觉，这是每个人会关心的，这也是我们的一个科学啊。我今晚上要说的第一件事情呢，今天我很高兴，我们这里很多的，佛教徒和非佛教徒，大家利用网络的平台，共同聚聚。其实现在，用这个，因特网啊，就是，这样的人是非常多的。但是真正里面求真理的人，寻找这个智慧和悲心的人呢，并不是很多的。所以，我今晚上第一个希望呢，我们在座的，利用网络的人呢，希望你们，不要浪费时间，一定要求真理、求真见，求真念，求智慧，因为现在这个社会很复杂，尤其是我们很多年轻人呢，自己没有，很好的这种思维的能力的这种铸剑，很容易被各种各样的眼花缭乱的外境会吸引和迷惑你，所以呢，我们当今这个时代当中呢，是非常特殊的一种文化现象啊。这种文化呢，很容易让人堕落，让人，会迷失方向。因此，第一个希望大家利用网络的时候需要真知真见。
And Rinpoche said, this is the all the teaching of the about Bodhicitta. And besides that, he has another few things what to mention, but he would take too much time because he knows that many people would go to sleep. And today, Rinpoche said he's very happy that there are so many people gathering through the internet to study Dharma together. And he said it is very good. And because in this special age, in this modern time, he knows that so many people they spend a lot of time on internet, but very few are really seeking the truth through internet. Very few are really learning the truth by taking this time. So Rinpoche encouraged us that do not waste any time and try to make more efforts, try your best to seek truth, to learn Dharma, and to learn all the useful things through and all kinds of opportunities. And he said that because during he said that because in this time there are so many things that we are very easily to get distracted by all different things, by all different views, and but nevertheless we should put our effort on study on learning the truth.
第二个希望。第二个希望呢，现在，这个世界就人们经常称为叫做地球村，地球上有许许多多的人类，这些人类都生活的方式和他利用的语言文字都不相同，因此我的希望呢，佛教这么很好的真理呢，主要来自于印度。后来呢，就是到藏地、汉地，以及这个其他国家的，所以我们有些年轻人懂世界各国的语言的人呢，我特别希望你们，用不同民族和不同国家的语言啦，弘扬和宣讲，带领就是许多不同生活方式的这些人们。我们我这边呢也尽量的培养各个国家的一些懂语言的、懂教理的这些人。我希望很多的人呢需要在这方面共同发心、共同努力。这样之后的话呢，我想对整个地球、对来自所有的生命和众生呢，都带来就无比的利益。所以这也是说大乘佛教的一种宗旨，因此呢，希望以后自己以前学过各通不通的这种文字语言呢，应该利用 在这个弘扬真理方面。
And the second hope is that, number two said today, the whole world, we usually call it, as a earth village. So, there are so many, different nations, different races, different human beings. They have different styles and different language. And, Rinpoche said that, when we're talking about Dharma, the precious Dharma, originally it's from India, and then it was spread to Tibet and China. And at this time, Rinpoche said, for those young peoples who know different language, who can speak different languages, Rinpoche hoped that they could, spread Dharma with different language to different people, so that we can use this precious Dharma to guide different people and help them also attain enlightenment. And Rinpoche said for himself, he's also try to educate some masters in his academy who can speak different language. And on the other hand, he also hoped that for those young people, they could put their effort, they could spread some energies, all this, also to spread the Dharma using different languages, and to put a seed to different nations, put a seed of Mahayana to different people. And in this way, we can really benefit all such beings in the whole world.
第三个呢，我要讲一下，感谢大家。第一个，非常感谢呢，我们各个地方的佛教的一些小组啊，佛教的一些组织啊，在这里面有许多发心人员，你们不止自己心呢，应该为众生，为弘扬真理呢，付出自己的最宝贵的时间和精力，同时呢，你们也会帮助了许多可怜的众生。那么这一点呢，我作为一个佛教徒呢，发自内心的非常感谢你们。
And the third one, Rinpoche said, and he wants to thank somebody. First of all, he said that he knows that there's so many studying groups organizations in different places, and for those studying groups or organizations, there's volunteers who already spent so much time and so much energy for the Dharma learning, for the spreading Dharma, for the benefiting of others, and he said he really wants to thank all of these people because of their effort.
第二个感谢呢，我们自备翻译中心，自备翻译中心呢，这两年以来，应该是无论是韩文翻成英文，英翻汉，在这方面就是做了非常大的贡献。如今我们在两年以来，大概佛教与科学方面的有180多个。文章和一些有180多篇，那么其中呢，就内容最殊胜的，我们编辑了2本书，可能中间就含了大概50多篇文章，所以这些发心人员呢，也是日日夜夜对佛教和科学呢就进行对比，佛教和科学里面的非常著名的一些西方和东亚的其他的国家的这些学者的这种文章呢，就是翻译成这个汉语。所以呢，我希望你们还要不断的努力，我不断的赞叹你们。
And the second is that no matter what the transmission center, the compassion and the wisdom transmission center, and there are so many people in this center. They either translate from English to Chinese or from Chinese to English, and they did a lot of work in the past 2 years. And Rinpoche said about the topic of Buddhism and science, just more than 180 papers were translated from English to Chinese, and we already selected more than 50 papers and composed them into two books. And Rinpoche said for those volunteers, they translated so many great papers that are written by Western or and Eastern scholars, and they did a lot of research about Buddhism and science, and really provide many knowledge in these areas. And Rinpoche said he hopes all of these volunteers could continue their work, and Rinpoche will also continue to thank all of you.
啊，最后一个感谢呢，我们这里的这么多人啊，我刚才看到网络上有这么多的人，已经利用了一个半小时的时间，听了我的胡言乱语，耽误了你们很多的时间。我看到前面有一个佛教徒，还有一个出家人呢，打了三次哈欠，这说明呢，时间不能太长，时间就是生命。你们今天利用你们的生命来接受或者说是共同学习呢，我最后的一种感恩，谢谢。
And the third one and the last one is that the motive what you said all of you, either in this Dharma Hall, in all, either locally or in the internet. And Rinpoche said he already spent 1.5 hours to give teachings and talking about different things. And he said he already noticed someone in front of him yawned already 3 times. And he realized that it is true that time is life, and life is time. So he really thanked all of you, spent 1.5 hours to study with all of us, and he would thank all of you.
Thank you.
저는 너희 단체 그반에 돈은 입에 잔은 다시 경계난 지랄론 주바이 수분 전에 도와드셔